exactly the same. So did you guys know what holiday yesterday was? Anyone?
Genocide Day.
National No Bra Day. Close. Very close. Oh my God. What a, like, can you think of a better way to wear, raise awareness for some breast cancer than just having your nips out all day, ladies? Woo! I like hate bras, you know, but they're kind of amazing because I do like to wear an underwire. That way, my titties are the first thing to enter the party. So you guys, I'm in my 20s, and it's like a very financially insecure time in my life. But fortunately, I am still hot enough to marry out of my tax bracket. But picking a boyfriend is like picking an insurance policy. Like, yeah, I really feel better that I know I have one, but I'm never really quite sure what the benefits are. You guys, I'm really slutty, but no one places any value on things that are easy, right? Sucks. Here's the thing, like, I'm not whining. Like, I have no problem finding great dick. The problem is, it's always attached to an asshole. Do you guys know the moment in your life when you peaked, like, looks-wise? I do. 26 years old, with my boyfriend at the time, wedding with all his friends from his hometown, right? I go into this wedding, and it felt like that reveal moment on Pimp My Car. You know, my Kelly Blue Book value was way up. Right until I drove right off the lot. And to make this transformation into this dainty, naturally pretty woman, I enlisted the help of one lady from every country in the Eastern Hemisphere. Like, I had a Japanese lady paint my chubby toes. I had a Russian woman squish down my labias and rip off my pubes, which, oh, I don't believe. Then a Korean woman just placed those hairs gently and individually on each and every eyelash. Somewhere, somebody skinned a Filipino lady, and some lovely tranny man glued it all over my hair to add volume so I could boost up my ego, hopefully, and it worked. All these people helping me. And then once I had my pretty on, I shimmied into my shiny blue dress, you guys. I must have looked like a toddler throwing a hissy fit, trying to get his mom to pick him up, just... But you know, like, once you got that dress on, it was like I secured myself into a Chinese finger trap. You know what I mean? And then I got inside the church, and this is where I got sticky, you guys. I looked amazing standing up. I never tried the dress on seated. This is my first Catholic wedding with all his friends. I had to go into the pews, and I realized, you guys, that I could not sit vertically. I had to sit on a slant. I was in a V position for the entirety of an hour-long Catholic service. And then we got to the prayers. Oh, thank God. Put down the thing. I had to rock myself and slingshot myself onto my knees. Good thing I had so much practice, you know? Once down here, I had to daintily take the pew in front of me and just pull myself up like an American Ninja Warrior back into that seated position. My boyfriend was not impressed. He broke up with me. Yeah. Do you know his reason? Because I'm not reborn. He broke up with me because he wanted me to find God. And I was raised like really fortunately, so I felt like I didn't need Jesus. Like I didn't need to pray for some cars or for some money. I could just go in the other room and ask my dad. He wanted me to find God. With a meal, 3 times a day, and I'm a really good patient. So I listened.